to everyone. This is Kelvin. I want to talk about the Navajo Nation Metal Fest 4D that happened on November 18th at Window Rock, Arizona. And the show was a festival with almost all indigenous bands. The only exceptions were mainly the headliners, In Flames and Havoc. So really sick show, and just wanted to show some clips and talk about some of the bands that I saw. I didn't get to the show when it started at 11. I think I got there around 1:30. I think Existence AD just ended their set, but I was able to check out Celestial Exile and pretty much all the bands that played. The only exception was Project BC. I did the In Flames meet and greet, and so that meet and greet kind of took place during the Project BC set, so I was kind of bummed that I missed that. But I'll just kind of talk about the show, the bands, and then just show some of the stuff I got. So the show started at 11, and a lot of the bands that started first I wasn't too familiar with, plus I had to kind of get some stuff situated before I, got to the show, run some errands before I went there and stayed there for the 12-hour show. But I was really excited. I did the In Flames meet and greet, and I'll show that and show some pictures I got with the band. But I'll start showing some clips and talking about some of the bands I played. So check this out. So the first band I saw was Celestial Exile. They're from San Carlos, Arizona, San Carlos Apache Reservation. They play a sick style of deathcore with some sick vocals and heavy breakdowns. Band I saw was Narbona from Crown Point, Mexico, Navajo tribe. Fairly new band. They play death metal, super heavy. Check it out. Salvation is Lost from Page, Arizona. They are like a deathcore, metalcore band. They had three members that played this lineup. They did an excellent job. Morbid Justice from Durango, Colorado. They're like a metalcore style band, similar to like Lamb of God and Trivium. Yeah, really cool band. Really dig their lead guitar style. Snahi, black metal band from Albuquerque, New Mexico. Started out as a one-man project, now a full band, and this was their first live appearance as a live band, which was an honor to see.
was Tribus from Gallup, New Mexico. They play a heavy groove metal style. Yeah, lots of groove that you can bang your head to. Really fun band to watch. Check them out. Then you have Wait the Dawn from Albuquerque, New Mexico. They play metalcore slash like deathcore style. Very melodic as well. Check them out. Then Graves of the Monuments from Page, Arizona. I was really excited to see these guys. They play a really interesting progressive style of metalcore slash deathcore. Really like them. From San Carlos, Arizona, San Carlos Apache Reservation. Yeah, these guys I feel like are getting bigger and bigger, making appearances on NAQPD and Sirius XM. Closed out the side stage with their brand of death metal slash thrash metal and really got the mosh pit going for the night. Really heavy band to see live. Signal 99 was the first band to play on the main stage. They're from Farmington, New Mexico, and they play like a industrial, almost kind of like nu metal. They did a cover of the band Dope, which kind of gave me an idea of where their influences are. Then one of the surprises of the night, Sage Cornelius. He plays the violin with a style of djent / deathcore and played a version of Devil Went Down to Georgia, which is amazing. Check it out. Under Exile from Shiprock, New Mexico, last band to play before the headliners. Yeah, they played some new music, their newest single, Glass in the Sage. Check it out. Then Havoc from Denver, Colorado played their brand of thrash metal to the hungry Navajo audience and also gave us lessons in math and grammar, which was pretty hilarious. And it was cool to see their bassist, Nick Shenzio. He's also a member of Job for a Cowboy. I think the last time I saw Havoc was in 2019 in Phoenix, Arizona. And I don't think he was with the band at that time, but it was cool to see them here. They definitely have a big following with the Navajo audience. Really got the mosh pits going, got the circle pits going, crowd surfers were everywhere, and yeah, overall amazing set. Thank you, Havoc. Then In Flames hit the stage around 10:30. Legendary band from Gothenburg, Sweden. One of the more influential bands, probably on the late 90s, early 2000s US metalcore scene. Yeah, they definitely influenced a bunch of bands from like Killswitch Engage, Darkest Hour, As They Lay Dying. Yeah, they influenced the whole scene. When I was in high school, that's kind of like when I picked up on them. Yeah, they had a really, really awesome set list. I was like really impressed. Really just amazed that they did some of the old stuff from their first album, which, you know, I don't really mosh, but, you know, I had to step in and do a little circle pit and kind of stand with all the people that were, you know, more active in the crowd, which was fun. And I felt like their newer material like got a bigger response from the audience, but it was cool seeing them, and I was like just, you know, really happy to see them play here on the reservation. I think this is only my second time seeing them play live, but definitely one of my favorite bands growing up. Check them out.
Some of the merch that In Flames had. I did the meet and greet and had to meet up in the front, so walking back the stage, and here are the guys doing a meet and greet. And I brought my vinyl, so I got that signed by the members of this lineup. Fucking awesome opportunity to do that. Got a autograph poster with the meet and greet, so here it is. I was really excited to see In Flames. I did the meet and greet, and I'd just been a fan of In Flames for a long time. I think in high school I kind of discovered the Clayman album, which I got right here. Probably my favorite album. I got the CD. They re-released it a few years ago with some re-recorded songs, but yeah, this probably one of my most favorite In Flames albums. But some of the early stuff, like the Gesture Race, they did some songs, not from this one, but from this album. They did Behind Space and Lunar Strain, which was really sick. And then they did a few songs off of Clayman, so I was really happy about that. And as far as the meet and greet, got some goodies. Here's an autographed set list. I thought I lost it, but I actually found it buried in all my stuff. But it's a signed set list, and can see all the songs that they did. I was actually surprised that a lot of the older stuff, all the old songs, didn't get much of a crowd reaction. I think most of the stuff, pretty much from after like the Cloud Connected soundtrack, Tearscape era, and the newer stuff too, it seems like that got a lot of good response from the audience. Yeah, back to the meet and greet. I was able to get my my album autographed, the new album from In Flames. So this is actually a really good album. I'm gonna have to listen to it a little more. I know, like, when it came out at first, there was a lot of hype behind it. Like there was a lot of writings that this was gonna be like back to the original, but there's only like two songs that kind of sound like old In Flames. And then I got the poster behind me, and got to meet the band and got pictures with the band. So really cool opportunity to meet the band. And yeah, it was just a cool festival altogether. Randall with Rancid Savage put together a sick lineup this year. Here's the festival shirt. It's on a purple and green. In the back of the shirt with Havoc and In Flames on the back. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it next year. This seems to be like a yearly thing that Rancid Savage puts together, so hopefully it's bigger, better, and yeah, I'll for sure be there. But yeah, thanks for checking this out, and yeah, be sure to check out all the bands that played there. All right, yeah, thank you.